Okay, we'll start now. Are you able to share the screen, right? Sorry, are you able to see the screen, right? Hello?
Yes, sir, we are able to see.
Okay. Okay, yesterday we saw some important annotations, right? We learned something in a Spring Boot. Now, based on that learnings, today we're going to do one small assignment. Okay, we'll do one small assignment. Here, I want to create this kind of layers: customer controller, customer service, and the customer repository. Okay, here customer controller, as usual, what we seen yesterday. Then we'll create one service class. Then this service class connect to the customer repository. This customer repository is not a real database. I want to use ArrayList as a database. Through that ArrayList, I want to do some crude operation. This is my intention. Through this assignment, you will be getting familiar with the various type of REST control, REST endpoint. Then when we need to use particular type of REST endpoint, those things we're going to understand. Apart from that, you're going to understand what is the proper way of constructing the web service endpoint. Okay, I'm planning to cover this many things today. Okay, by doing this assignment. Now we're going to create a one Spring Boot project. I'm going to say com dot rest dummy crude. REST dummy crude, that is, I want to get REST services with a crude operation. It's not a real database. Okay, so here I need to com.itgarden is a group name, application name is a REST dummy crude, then description, okay, leave it as it is. Package name, I have to make it as a com.itgarden. Now we are going to create a REST web application, RESTful web service application. For that, we need to select dependencies. What is the dependency we need to select? Web. Spring Web is enough. I am selecting that. Now I'm going to generate the project. I'll keep here, I'll go to keep here. Okay. Project generated, extracting here. Now I want to import this project in my IntelliJ. File new, project from existing source. It is available here, right? Select that folder, select that pom.xml file. You should not select this folder. You have to select that pom.xml file. Okay, then new window. Okay. Yeah, project got imported. I'm going to rename it to simple, make it as application. Create one package called controller. Then creating one more package, service, creating one more package, repository, then package entity. Okay, in the controller control package, I'm going to create one class called customer controller. I am making this class as a RESTful Web Service class by using @rest controller annotation. Here I am going to create one entity object called customer. Private int. Private int id. Id, then private string name, private string address, private double fee. The same object after what we saw, the same object I'm creating, then total value. Double. Then I want to create a constructor for this. Generate. I'm going to create a getter setter. Then generate constructor. Yeah, constructor is created. Okay. Now we're going to design the REST service endpoint. Okay. First we have to create an adding a new customer. Public void add customer. Public void add customer. Then I want to return customer object. As of now, keeping here none. Then public customer update customer. Then public list customer get all customer. Then public customer get customer by ID. Then public void delete customer. That's it. So this is the REST endpoint I want to create. This is the method for creating a REST endpoint. Okay. This is the post mapping, right? Post mapping. I am saying, I don't want to say anything here. Right? Post mapping. Whenever called URL, I want to execute this particular method. Okay, so if you want to design a REST endpoint in proper manner, we need to structure your REST endpoint accordingly, according to your collection, according to your resource, you need to design our REST endpoint. Okay, here in the class level, I'll going to say one mapping using request mapping. I am saying here API slash customers. I am saying API slash customers. This is a common path to access customer object. API slash customer is a common path to access a customer object. Okay. If you want to access this this particular API, what you have to do? HTTP colon localhost 8080. That meaning you are calling up to this line, you are calling a, you are accessing the server. From this server, I want to access the API. Under this API, I need to access some resource. That resource either customer, either product, either vendor or employee, any resource it can be, right? So in our example, I want to access one resource called customers. One resource for customers. Okay. Now through this endpoint, we are understanding that. We are trying to access customer resource from the collection. So this is a plural. We have to keep it as a plural. That meaning you are interacting with the customer database in your REST server. Okay. This path is a common for all the methods, all the method endpoint. Now, I don't want to put anything here. I don't want to put any path here. Whenever say this, whenever say this, and the client side, whenever say this particular endpoint, then if you're going to select post, that meaning you are calling this particular endpoint. You are calling this particular endpoint. Okay. Then if customer want to update some, client want to update some customer. In such a case, I can use put mapping. Then we have to say what customer ID you want to update. That I am saying here. Okay. Now this endpoint we can access like this. Customers, I am from this customer resource, I want to access one customer. That is customer ID set 10. So this customer I want to update. Why? Because I am saying here put map. It's a put method. Okay. Then if you want to view all the customer, if you want to view all the customer, we have to say get map. Then we don't have to mention any path here, because I can use this path itself. Whenever you say this, whenever you say like this, then if you select get, it will going to call this endpoint method. This is going to call this endpoint method. Customers select this endpoint, then they are going to select get method. So this method will get invoked. If they are using post, this method get invoked. This method get invoked. Okay. So through this endpoint, now I am able to access all the customers. Now I want to view only one customer. For that also we need to use get mapping. Then we have to mention the path. Customer ID. Then we need to say same thing. It's a get. If customer select this endpoint, then they selected get method. This method get invoke and return particular customer. And return particular customer to the client side. Delete mapping. Now I want to remove one customer. Which customer you want to remove? That path I am saying here. Delete mapping, I am passing customer ID in the path. When you access this endpoint, when you select delete as a method, this particular endpoint method get invoked, delete the customer. Okay, now this URL looks like very neat, right? Through this URL, you can understand what you are doing. If client read this URL, they can understand, okay, this guy is accessing the customer. Okay, if the client is selecting this particular URL, they are saying post means they are adding one customer to the customer database. They are adding one customer to the customer table. Then for slash customers, slash if you pass customer ID, if you pass put method, they are trying to update. If they pass get method, they are trying to view the customer. If they pass delete method, they are trying to delete the customer. So through this way, we have to construct the web service endpoint. Okay, consumer, the client easily understand what is the purpose of the particular endpoint. Okay. Now I want to tell one more thing here. Apart from this UR endpoint, this is a billing system. This is my billing system project which I developed. I think people who don't have access to this project, let me know. I will share this project. Okay. So this is a biller controller. There is a biller controller, right? This is a biller controller. Using this biller controller, we can do the payment. We can view the bill. We can delete the bill. All manipulation we can do using this biller controller. This is my biller controller common endpoint path. Common endpoint path. Whatever methods available here. Endpoint methods available here. If you want to access this method, we have to use this particular path. Then followed by respective endpoint path. We have to say. Okay. Just I will go to explain how I am constructed this endpoint here. This is the common endpoint for to access the billing resource. If you want to view the if you want to add a new bill, we can use this this particular endpoint http://localhost:8080/api/private/bills. If you say like this, if you use post method, you are adding a new bill. Okay. Why I'm keeping it private? The reason I'm keeping it private is this method is not accessible in public. Publicly we cannot access this. Privately we cannot access. We can access if user provide username and a password, then only this particular endpoint accessible. Otherwise it's cannot access. That's the reason I keep it as a private. Then if I say bill number 111 bill number, now this bill number through this endpoint I can view, I can update, I can delete. Three operation I can do. For example, if you pass get method, I can view. If you pass put method, I can update. If you pass delete method, I can delete that particular bill number. Then using this for all, we can create as well as a view all bill. If you pass get, can view all bill. After that, one more thing I want to tell. Then slash items. When you say items, for example, if you're going to supermarket, you are buying some product. For example, let's say you are buying rice, you are buying vegetables, then you are buying some other item. Okay, totally you purchase 10 different items. For 10 different items, each item it has a unique payment. Each item, for rice it has a unique payment, for vegetable it has a unique payment, for other item it has a unique payment. For each item it has a unique payment. I want to see all those items. I want to see all those item detail. For that I can say items. If we say items get, it will return the all the items belongs to that particular bill number, belongs to the particular bill number. Then bill number 111 slash items. Then I want to view one particular item price. I want to see the rice item price. So in this bill number, there is items, 10 items. From the 10 item, I want to view particular payment, particular item payment. Say get method. If you want to delete, you can delete. If you want to update, you can update. Okay. Through this manner, we need to construct the web service endpoint. So this looks like very neat. Right. So by seeing this particular endpoint, you can understand that this is not accessed globally. Using bills, we are accessing the bills resource. From the bill resource, we are accessing the particular bill number. From the bill number, you are trying to retrieve all the items. From the items, you are viewing particular bill, particular item information. So by reading this endpoint, the client must understand what this particular endpoint is doing. In such a way, we need to design our endpoint. Okay, these are the standards we have to follow to design a RESTful web service endpoint. Okay. Any question?
No.
Okay. Okay, now you understand that how we need to construct the RESTful web service endpoint. After designing the endpoint properly, we need to give proper HTTP status code. We need to give proper HTTP status code. For example, here whenever you are creating a new customer, we should not say simply success. We have to tell what's happening in the server. Okay, whenever you add some resource, we have to tell one status called HTTP status dot created. That meaning 201. 201 meaning created. Whenever add any resource to the server, we need to give proper status to the client. Since you are a new customer, so we have to give a response to the client. Yeah, you created the customer. So I am sending a status code created. It's a 201. If it is success, we can say simply okay 200. That's it. Okay, if it is an error, we need to give proper status code error, that is not found, bad request, forbidden. Now, based on the error scenario, you have to provide proper status code to the client. So this is the proper way to designing your RESTful web service endpoint. Okay. Now we're going to see all the things now. Okay, now I have done that template, RESTful template here. Now we're going to focus on implementation. I'll go into service class. I'll come from service class. Sorry, I'm coming from the repository class, not service. I'm making this class as a service class, repository class. Then I'll going to declare one array list, a list customer, customers equal to new array list. Public void save. The save method accept customer as an object. Then if customer dot get ID equal to 0. This is not a database, right? We have to write all the code. Okay. Then int key equal to 0. I want to generate some unique key for each customer. If it is customer, if the customer object ID is containing 0, that meaning we are creating a new customer. Okay, then so customer dot set ID equal to plus key, plus key. I don't want to write all those logic. I will going to take that logic from yesterday's example. Then customer dot set total value. Then okay. So this is the customer save, adding a new customer or updating a existing customer. Okay, now this method accepting a customer as a parameter. I'm taking the fee. Then here I'm checking ID is a 0. If ID is a 0, then I'm increasing key value 0 to 1. Very first time key is a 0, right? So it's increased to 1. That meaning key became 1. I'm setting that as a 1. Then I'm taking, this is no need. Then calculating a tax, then assigning total value fee plus tax, then setting a total value to customer dot set total. After that, I'm adding customer dot add. I'm adding the customer object to the array list. Okay. Let's see this working fine or not. Customer service. This is also service class at service. Public customer. Here we have to say at AutoWire private customer repository, customer repository. I want to add this list. Okay. Return customers. No, I am going to add only customer. Whatever customer newly added, I want it in only that customer. That is the correct customer. Customer. New customer. Okay. New customer. Then return new customer. Here I will going to change return type as a customer. Okay. Then now in the control method, how to auto wire. Private customer service, customer service return customer service dot save. Here we have to pass request body, which is coming from client side. Request body customer customer. I am passing that customer object here. That's it. Okay, now we got to check this ad is working properly or not. So it started our local is 8080, right? Okay, now we need to copy this entire thing. It's a post mapping. Okay, it's a post mapping. Here, what is the customer ID? You don't have to pass. Customer ID don't have to pass. Customer name, customer address. What is the attribute here? Attribute is name, right? Name, yeah. Name. Address, then fee. We don't have to pass total value. Okay, that's it. Now I want to invoke this particular endpoint. I want to invoke this particular endpoint method. For that, we need to say localhost 8080 API customer. Then we have to select post method. Okay, the same I did here. Okay, let's see what's happening. See, customer is saved. The ID generated one. Then ID generated one. Fee is 2000. GST with tax calculated 2200. Now I want to add one more customer. Suresh Temple Street. 3000. So Suresh also added. Now it's showing as added, but we need to check really it's really added or not in the array list. For that, what you have to do? We have to check get mapping, right? So get mapping method not implemented yet. We need to implement. We'll do that now. Here public list customer. This get all customer. I'm saying get find all simply returning customer. That's it. Simply returning customer. So after adding, whenever call this find all method, I am returning the customer's array list. Customer array list, whatever data available in the array list, that will returned here. Okay. In a service class, I want to call that public list customer get all customer. Customer repository dot find all return. The customer class, the same thing. I need to call customer service dot get all customer. Okay. Now this get all customer calling the repository find all. The find all I am saying find all instead of find all method. I am just returning this array list. That's it. Okay. Now we are going to first you need to add the customer, because after restarting the data will vanish because I am storing only array list, not storing the database. So data destroyed. added. Now, Deepan first street, I am saying 200. Deepan is added. Now I want to view. Get. For get also, we have to use the same endpoint. Get also we have to use same endpoint, but we need to change the method, get method. Request body is not required. Okay, that's no one. If you use get method, don't consider this request body even if you have. I'm going to remove that. So here whatever I added is printing up. Suresh and Deepan I added. Okay, now I'm going to add one more. Vijay. It's added. Get method. I am saying now. Send. So here Suresh, Deepan, Vijay. Three data is available in the array list. It's coming from the array list. Okay, whenever call get all customer, I am calling service.get all customer. The service.get all customer calling find all method from customer repository. The customer repository find all method. I am just simply returning the customer array list. Okay. After adding some data, I am calling this returning all the data. Next thing, I want to view particular customer. I want to view only one customer. If you want to view three or two, anything, I want to view. For that, I need to return one more method in repository class. Find by ID. Long customer. Find by ID long, for int customer. Int customer ID. From the list, we need to find out the right customer. Okay, for that, I'm going to use dot stream dot filter dot C. C dot get ID equal to customer ID dot get customer ID dot find any dot get. So customer equal to, then I want to return this customer.
Sir, can you explain that line number 31, sir, little bit?
This is lambda expression, the part of Java 8 feature. Okay, I cannot go in depth. It's a big concept of lambda expression. See here, customers dot stream. Stream is a Java 8 feature. Okay, stream means whatever data available in the customer, right? Customer list that will come here. Okay, from that stream, I want to filter particular customer. I want to filter based on my condition. I want to filter the customer data based on my condition. For that, I'm using filter method. That filter method accepts a predicate. Predicate is a one function, one concept in a Java 8. Through that predicate, I am finding here. The filter, comma C, right? C is the input argument. In that predicate, I am passing input argument as a customer. Whatever data available inside a customer, the first item come here. I am passing that input. From that item, I am taking the get ID. That get ID match with this customer ID. I am taking that customer and assigning to here. Okay. Siranjeevi, right? Huh? The question asked.
Yes, sir.
Siranjeevi, if you have still confusion, you can call personally, but I don't want to explain now here. Okay. You call personally, okay. I will ready to explain about this. Okay.
Sure.
So this is the line we're going to take the customer which matches with this customer ID. Okay. If you want to use the legacy code, we have to use a normal for loop only. For loop, in the for loop, we need to check the ID equal to match the customer ID matches with the customer ID. Then I want to break the for loop. Then I need to assign that particular customer. So if you are not comfortable with this code, I will going to use that old style code also, no problem. Okay, for each customer C, customers, if C dot get ID equal to customer ID, then I am saying customer equal to null. I am saying that then customer equal to C dot get, I am asking current customer, then break. Okay, so this many line happening here, the single line. Okay, this is for your reference. I am keeping this. Okay, but I want to use only this. Okay, this line I am using here only, using Java init feature. I am restarting the server. I want to add the customer again. Added Suresh, first string. Then location. Third string. Now I want to view all the customer, so I am able to view. Okay, now I want to view particular customer for that. So let's say I want to view second customer. It's not coming. It's giving status, but it's not coming. Let's check that. No errors. No errors. Okay, but it's not coming. Why? Oh, that method is just not implemented. Sorry guys, the service class, we have not implemented the method itself. We have the method customer get customer by id in customer id. Okay, then customer deposit dot get find by id passing customer. The controller we have to say path variable here. Path variable int customer ID. You have to pass this customer ID. Okay, now this is a get mapping, get customer ID. This get mapping having a path called customer ID. You are passing a customer ID parameter. As a parameter, user has to pass here customer ID. That value will substitute in the customer ID variable using at path variable annotation. Yesterday, I explained about this. Using path variable, whatever parameter we are passing in the path, that path value we can take it here. Okay, now I am passing the customer ID here. This customer ID will go to service class. From the service class, I am passing this customer ID in the repository find by ID. Repository find by ID, using this customer, I am checking this customer ID available or not in the customer collection. If it is there, I am returning that customer. Okay. Server started. Again, I need to start. Okay. Post method. Added. Kumar. Straight, then 2, added, then Ravi, tester, then 2, 1, added. So now we can see here all the customers. We will see all the customer. Now our intention is we need to view only one customer. See, it's coming. Whatever customer you want to view, I'm able to get that. Now I want to view second customer. It's coming here. I want to view first customer. I'm able to view that. Okay. Then next one is what? Next one is we have to update the customer. For that, we need to write one more method. Update customer, we don't have to write. Update customer, we have a serve method. The serve method itself will do the update as well as add. Then we need to create a delete customer, right? We need to create delete customer. Delete by ID, then customer ID. Then we have to the same logic. If to copy and paste it here, then from the customer array list, remove that object. Remove customer. I don't want to return anything here, just to void. Okay. Now this method we need to call in service class. Public void delete by ID in customer ID, then customer repository dot delete by ID customer ID. Okay, then in the customer controller delete by ID we have to call customer service dot delete by ID customer ID. Just to copy this path variable here. Customer ID. Okay. The update customer also we have to call the same one. Update customer. The update customer is passing request body as a customer. This customer contains whatever modification they have to do. That modification available in the customer object. That customer object I am sending to the same save method. The save method will go into update the customer in the repository class. Okay. Now we have done all the methods, all the CRUD operations. We'll test that now. Post method. I want to add a customer. Added. Suresh. One straight. I'm passing some dummy value. Then K7 three straight. I'm passing 700. Okay. Next is I want to delete. I want to delete second record. Select that. Select the delete. Delete mapping, delete method, that's it. It will not return any response. It's a void, right? So it's giving this status equal to 200. Okay. Now we'll check by getting all the customers. The 2 should not come now. See, 2 is not coming. 2 is deleted. Okay. Now I want to update. I want to update some customer. Let's see it's updating or not. I'll copy the first one. Just to paste it here. Then it's a Ravi 1, Ravi Kumar. I'm saying Ravi Kumar. Then street. Okay. Then send. Ravi Kumar. Ravi is not updated. I think it's not updated. Okay, let's see that. Yeah, I need to select a put mapping, right? Put mapping. Yeah, put mapping. Kumar. Send. Method not allowed. Method not allowed. Sorry, we need to pass which ID you want to update. I want to update 1th customer. I want to update 1th customer. I forgot to pass that. See, Ravi Kumar is coming. Test Street 2 is coming. Now we'll confirm that by retrieving all the data. So previously it was Ravi. I changed to Ravi Kumar. Previously the address is at Test Street 2. I think the Test Street. It changed to Test Street 2. We'll verify by getting all the data. Ravi Kumar is not updated properly. Something, some logical problem available. We need to resolve that. Okay. Now I'll go to add this. I'm going to update. Put, I want to say one. Just to pop this. Fee, then Suresh one. I say Suresh one. Now ID equal to one. I'll say. Yeah, I'm getting all the customer. In the update section, I'm getting all the customer. Then here I'm calculating it. Then customers dot remove, then adding it, adding the customer. Okay. Okay, it's coming. Suresh one is not at all coming. One. Update customer. Update customer is a total value. Oh, sorry. I have to pass this. Yeah, this time it will work. Here what I'm doing is the update section I wanted to I'm finding the whatever customer I want to update. I'm finding that customer here. I want to remove that customer. I want to remove that customer. I'm removing it. Then whatever customer they wanted to update, that customer data in that customer request body, I am doing the GST calculation. Then I'm adding that customer to our list. This is the correct way of doing.
Sir, for debugging, we did something in the IDE. Can you please explain that?
Address, button. So I want to change back to this. Send back to is Suresh Kumar. Then I don't want to pass total value. Okay. Now I want to pass select put method. ID is a 1. Suresh 1 to Suresh Kumar. Yeah, now it's Suresh 1 to Suresh Kumar is coming. Then get mapping. Get, if you say get also, you should come. Suresh Kumar is coming. Now it's working perfectly. Okay. The reason is, you understand what is the reason it's not working previously. Why? Because this customer having some, this customer list having some data, right? Data. In the request, we are sending one customer which we want to update, Okay, this request, these are coming for request body. The request body contain the data which you want to update. Okay, now here I am finding the customer using this this line. I am finding the customer, then I am offering that customer data to here, offering the customer data to here, okay, based on that ID. Now this update customer, this should not be update customer, this should be old customer, old value customer, okay, old value customer, okay. This old value customer, previously I have added here, the previously I have added, I should not add, I want to remove that, I want to remove that. After removing that, I want to add that whatever updated customer available here, that customer you add here. Okay, that's the reason previously not working. Once I change it, that it start working. Okay, this returning the old customer data. That data I am removing from the list. Then I am adding to the this customer object to the array list, which is the newly modified. Okay. Someone is asked how to debug, right? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So if you want to debug, we have to start the application first in debug point. We have to start the application in debug mode. Okay. Right click, debug application.main. You have to say debug application.main. Generally, we'll say run. You say right click debug application.main. Otherwise, run debug application. Okay. When you say that, your application start in debug mode. Debug mode, okay. Okay, I have some issue here. What's happening? What's going on here? I don't know. I want to find out. So, wherever you want to debug, in that place, you need to click. Just to click it. It will show one red run plug, okay. Okay, just click it. Then, if you send a request, what will happen? It will come under point here. What happened? It's a post method, right? Now I'm going to call a post method. That meaning, It will come here. Add customer will come. That was, I'm adding a new customer, so it will come here. Then from the customer service, it will call the serve method. From this customer service, it will call this method, right? So I'm keeping the debug point here, right? So it will come under stop here. It will not execute. I'm sending it. So automatically come here, right? So from this point, you can debug. You can see some arrow here. This array is a step over. Step over nothing but go to next line. That means go to next line. It will give the what is the value in the fee. Also, it will give the what is the value in the customer. All the value you can see. So through this way, you can figure it out what is the problem in your code. Okay. You can go next like that. Then I'm ending this. Now I want to debug from here, from the controller I want to debug, so that I put the breakpoint here, right? Send. So I put the breakpoint here, so it's come to the add customer, it come to the add customer, stop, it's not executing. There is a step in two. If you say step over, what will happen? It will come to here, it will stop. If you say step in two, it will go to inside the save method. So it's going to inside the save method. Now if you say step into it, it will go to inside the save method or repository class. Now from here you can debug step by step. Okay. Got it? Okay, this is the crude operation we have done without using database. Without using database, we have done the one small crude operation using array list. Okay, now we are going to see how to connect with the database. Now we are going to see how to connect with the database. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.